Hello students, from this lecture we are going to start chapter 10 microbes in human welfare. Here main topics are microbes in household products, microbes in industrial products, in sewage treatment, microbes in production of biogas, microbes as biocontrol agents and microbes as biofertilizers. So this way this chapter is totally related with microbes useful to various ways. As you know, on this earth living organisms are there. They are plants and animals. As well as microbes are the major component of biological system on this earth. You have studied about the diversity of living organism in class 11 also. Do you remember which kingdoms among the living organisms contain microorganisms? Which are the ones that are only microscopic? Try to recall this. Microbes are present everywhere, in soil, water, air, inside our bodies and that of other animals and plants also. They are present even at sites where no other life form could possibly exist. These sites are mainly there deep inside the geysers, thermal vents, where the temperature may be as high as 100 degrees centigrade. Deep in the soil, under the layers of snow, several meters thick, and in highly acidic environments also. So we can say they are found everywhere. Microbes are diverse. They are like protozoa, bacteria, fungi, microscopic animal and plant virus, viroids, and also they are prions, that are proteinaceous infectious agents. So this way, this type of microbes, they are observed on this earth. They are distributed everywhere on this earth. Bacteria and fungi, they can be grown on nutritive media to form colonies which can be seen by naked eyes, and they are very useful in study of microorganisms. Microbes, they can be cause diseases in human beings, plants and animal. So many microbes are there which are actually disease-caused organisms. Several microorganisms, they are also useful to man in diverse way. So, we can say that they can cause diseases in animals and plants, but this should not make you think that all microbes are harmful. Several microbes, they are useful to man in diverse way. Some of the most important contribution of microbes to human welfare we are going to study in this chapter in detail. First of all, let's start microbes in household products. You would be surprised to know that we use microbes or products derived from microbes every day. So, common example of this production is curd from milk. Microorganisms such as lactobacillus and others, they are commonly known as lactic acid bacteria. In short, it is also known as LAB. They grow in milk and convert it to curd. So, conversion from milk to curd is due to this. During this growth, the LAB produce acids that coagulate and partially digest the milk proteins. A small amount of curd added to the fresh milk as inoculum or starter contain millions of LAB, which at suitable temperature multiply, thus converting milk to curd, which also improves its nutritional quality by increasing vitamin B12. It is very important in our stomach also. This LAB, it means lactic acid bacteria, they play very beneficial role in checking disease causing microbes. Dough, which is used for making foods such as dosa and idli, is also fermented by bacteria, which is also a type of microbe. Puff up appearance of dough is due to the production of CO2, carbon dioxide gas. Can you tell which metabolic pathway is taking place resulting in the formation of CO2? Try to recall this. Where do you think the bacteria for this fermentation come from? Similarly, the dough which is used for making bread is fermented using baker's yeast. Its biological or scientific name is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. A number of traditional drinks and foods are also made by fermentation by the microbes. Toddy, a traditional drink of some parts of southern India, is made by fermenting sap from plants. Microbes are also used to ferment fish, soybean and bamboo shoots to make foods. So this way it's very useful to mankind. You know all about cheese. Cheese is one of the oldest food item in which microbes were used. Different varieties of cheese are known by their characteristic texture, flavor and taste, the specificity coming from the microbes used. Some examples of this type of cheese: the large holes in Swiss cheese are due to production of a large amount of carbon dioxide by a bacterium. Its scientific or biological name is Propionibacterium shermani. Another type, that is Roquefort cheese, is ripened by growing a specific fungi on them, which gives them a particular flavor. So this way, this production is also take place by microbes and variously it is useful to mankind. So this way, microbes, they are very useful in household products. Now, microbes in industrial production. In industry, microbes are used to synthesize number of products valuable to human beings. Beverages and antibiotics are some examples of this. Production on an industrial scale require growing microbes in very large vessel, and these vessels are known as fermenters. Fermented beverages. Microbes, especially yeast, have been used from time for the production of beverages like wine, beer, whiskey, brandy or rum. For this purpose, the same yeast, it means that named Saccharomyces cerevisiae, used for bread making, and commonly it is called brewer's yeast. It is used for fermenting malted cereals and fruit juices to produce ethanol. Do you recollect the metabolic reactions which result in the production of ethanol by yeast? Try to recall it. Depending on the type of the raw material used for fermentation and the type of processing. It means with or without distillation, different type of alcoholic drinks are obtained. For example, wine and beer are produced without distillation. But whiskey, brandy and rum, they are produced by distillation of the fermented broth. This figure is about fermenters. It's actually picture taken from fermentation plants. Now, as we know, in industries, microbes, they are used to synthesize a number of products which are valuable to human beings. And this way, for production of industrial scale, is required growing microbes in very large vessels. As you can see in this picture also, this type of large vessels are there and they are known as fermenters. Antibiotics. Antibiotics, they are produced by microbes and they are regarded as one of the most significant discoveries of the 20th century and have greatly contributed towards the welfare of the human society. You have also some idea about antibiotics. What is meaning of antibiotics? Anti is a Greek word and its meaning is against, and bio, as you know, its meaning is life. Together, they mean against life in the context of disease-causing organism. But with reference to human being, they are pro-life and not against. Antibiotics, they are chemical substances which are produced by some microbes and can kill or retard the growth of other. It means disease-causing microbes. So, this way, antibiotics, they are very useful to mankind. You are familiar with the commonly used antibiotic named penicillin. Do you know that penicillin was the first antibiotic to be discovered? And it was a chance discovery. Alexander Fleming, very well-known scientist, while working on staphylococci bacteria, once he observed a mold growing in one of his unwashed culture plates around which staphylococci could not grow. He found out that it was due to chemical produced by the mold and he named it penicillin after the mold, Penicillium notatum. Its full potential as an effective antibiotic was established much later by Ernest Chain and Howard Florey. This antibiotic was extensively used to treat American soldiers wounded in World War II. Fleming, Chain and Florey, they were awarded the Nobel Prize in 1945 for same discovery. After penicillin, other antibiotics were also purified from some other microbes. Can you name some other antibiotics and find out their sources? Try to do it. Antibiotics have greatly improved our capacity to treat deadly diseases. Some of these diseases, they are plague, whooping cough, it means Kali Khasi in local language, diphtheria, local name is a Galgotu, and leprosy, which is commonly known as Kushta rog, which used to kill millions all over the globe. Today, we can't imagine world without antibiotics. So this antibiotics, these chemicals, they are very useful to mankind to cure some diseases. Chemical, organic acids, enzymes and other bioactive molecules. Microbes are also used for commercially and industrial production of certain chemicals. They are like organic acids, alcohols and enzymes. Some examples are like that. The producers are Aspergillus niger, which is a type of fungus, is of citric acid. Acetobacter acetae, which is a bacterium, is for acetic acid. Clostridium butyllicum, so bacterium again, and this for butyric acid. Lactobacillus, again bacterium, this for lactic acid. Saccharomyces cerevisiae is this for production of ethanol. So this yeast is used to commercial production of ethanol. Now enzymes. Microbes are also used for production of enzymes. Lipases are used in detergent formulation and are helpful in removing oily stains from the laundry. You must have noticed that bottled fruit juice bought from the market are clear as compared to the housemade this type of juices. Why it is so? This is because the bottled juice are clarified by the use of pectinases and proteases. They are also type of enzyme used in bottled juice. Streptokinase, it is produced by the bacterium named Streptococcus and modified by genetic engineering, is used as a cloth buster for removing clots from the blood vessels of patients who have undergone myocardial infarction leading to heart attack. So this way, enzymes like lipase, pectinase and proteases, streptokinase, they are useful variously to mankind. Some bioactive molecules, they are also useful. This bioactive molecules, cyclosporin A, it is used as an immunosuppressive agent in organ transplant patients. It is produced by the fungus, which is also one type of microbe. It is named Trichoderma polysporum. Another, that is statins, is produced by the yeast. Its name is Monascus purpureus. It has been commercialized as blood cholesterol lowering agents. It acts by competitively inhibiting the enzyme responsible for synthesis of cholesterol. So this way, the uses of microbes as a chemicals, it's a useful, their products are citric acid, acetic acid, then butyric acid and lactic acid. As an enzyme, they are useful as a lipase, as a pectinase and proteases. Lipase is useful for laundry detergent, pectinase is for bottle juices, and another type of enzyme is like streptokinase, used as clot buster to remove clots, as well as some are useful as a bioactive molecules. They are like cyclosporin A, which is used as immunosuppressive agent. Actually, it is provided to patients which has undergone for organ transplantation. And another bioactive molecules, its name is statins. it is used as blood cholesterol lowering agent. So this way, microbes, they are useful as chemicals, enzymes and other bioactive molecules.